Morning, beautiful people. This is Bread from the Beach. It's a great thing just to spend this time with you this morning. And wanted to share a passage of scripture that really over the years is one that has been unpacked in my life through the Holy Spirit and through experience in terms of walking out this journey back to the house. It is out of Romans 14, 17. Should be a passage that most of us all are familiar with, but simply says that the kingdom of God is more than meat or drink. It's different than what we think of in terms of kingdoms of the world. But it's more than meat and drink. It is about righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. The kingdom of God is within us. Jesus simply says, don't look here or there for the kingdom, but the kingdom of God is within you. One of the beautiful things that took place for us on the day of Pentecost was that when the Holy Spirit came to indwell the believer and to empower the believer to get about the business of the kingdom, where we would be His witnesses and where we would minister under the power of the Holy Spirit, through the power of the Holy Spirit, and that kingdom life would be released through us into the lives of people and into the circumstances that we are in and into the atmosphere where people come into an awareness of the presence of the Lord. So kingdom life and kingdom living is not something that we just point to after we die, but there's a saying that's been familiar to me in my journey. Maybe it has been to some of you, but that we are in the kingdom on the way to the kingdom. That the kingdom of God is real now. When Jesus prayed and was teaching His disciples to pray, He was simply saying, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. He was saying, in this realm, we want to release kingdom life, and that life can be real today, it can be real tomorrow. And the kingdom of God is not something that you put your hands on and touch and set it up, but there is a King who lives on the inside of us, and His name is King Jesus. And the Holy Spirit enables us to be wedded together with Jesus so that as we submit to the rule and reign of Jesus, then that is where the kingdom of God is. For example, if you want to know the kingdom of God in your marriage, then let Jesus be at the center of your marriage and be submitted to His Lordship in that place. If you want to know the kingdom of God in your finances, then you submit to the reign and rule of Jesus in the area of your finances. The kingdom of God is about being submitted as we make our way back to the house. But in that sense, the kingdom of God is real now as we yield and submit to the King of Kings. Just some thoughts today. I challenge you. Just take a good look at your life and determine those areas where you are submitted, because I'm telling you, those are the places where you can experience the kingdom. But the places where you exercise that you're in charge, you're in control, you have a right to be in control, hey, you can miss the kingdom very easily. But Jesus simply says, the kingdom of God really is within you. Submit and yield and experience the reality of the kingdom of God on the way to the kingdom. This has been Bread from the Beach. Thank you and be blessed.